Good evening, everyone. I am Dr. Nupur Gupta, a PCOS health expert from Well Woman Clinic, and I work as a director in the Department of Obstetrics and Gynecology at Fortis Memorial Research Institute, Gurugram. Our topic for today is polycystic ovaries and contraception, because we want to celebrate today, 30th September, which is last day of September, because it carries with it two important things for a woman. One is Polycystic Ovarian Syndrome Awareness Month, and another was the World Contraception Day, which just went by. So our topic for discussion is choices and challenges that we give to women with polycystic ovaries. So contraceptive pills in polycystic ovaries are needed for cycle regularization and correction of acne, hirsutism, and so many other problems. There are combined pills, which are combination of estrogen and progesterone, that are prescribed on individual needs. And there are a lot of challenges, a lot of myths and misconceptions related to this treatment. Today we will discuss that how hormonal treatment will benefit them when they need it as a contraceptive, or they need it for managing the symptoms of polycystic ovarian syndrome. So we have with us today Ms. Mehak Sethia. She's a physiotherapy student, and welcome Mehak, and I would like Mehak to introduce herself.
Thank you, ma'am, and good evening, everyone. I am Mehak Sethia. I am a physiotherapy student, and I myself has PCOS, so that's why I like to invite experts so that they can give correct information, and I like to spread awareness on that. Thank you.
Yeah. So, Mehak, can we start with our today's session?
Yes, ma'am. Let's dive into the questions.
Yeah.
So, my first question is, which birth control pill is the best for PCOS?
Yes, Mehak. If we talk about birth control pills, they are commonly known as contraceptive pills or combination pills, which have combination of estrogen and progesterone hormones, and that mimic the natural cycle in females. So these hormones are given to prevent or inhibit ovulation when they are used as a contraceptive. For women who don't need as a contraception, for them it helps to regularize their cycles, to decrease the size of ovarian cysts, and to decrease the hormone-related side effects of polycystic ovaries. If we talk about hormone-related side effects, it means acne. So they will have a clearer skin. We mean hirsutism, that is extra hair growth, that will be reduced. Another thing is missing of periods, which will not happen. Period pain, lighter and regular periods, and also it prevents the long-term side effects. So birth control pills have many advantages, and we need to customize that which one is best for which person.
Okay. So, are there any other birth control options for them?
Mehak, birth control options. One is the oral one, which we just talked about. There are other hormonal contraceptives that are available. One is a skin patch or a contraceptive patch, which will also have estrogen, progesterone according to the cycle that women need. And it is applied on the skin for 21 days and removed for 7 days. And similarly, there is a vaginal ring, which also has a combination of both. So depending on who is comfortable with what, in these two things, you don't need to pop a pill every day, but they are not very readily available in India. So for Indian women, choice is more of contraceptive pills that we have.
Mm-hmm. Okay. But we are all worried about the side effects. So what they can be?
Yeah, this is one of the common worries that women face, and especially in India, they are very fearful of taking the hormonal pills. Yes, initially any pill that you take which has hormones or doesn't have hormone, you might face some amount of nausea, slight headache, some mood changes, or maybe soreness in breast. There might be some spotting. And some people might have issues related to weight. Usually weight gain does not happen, but there are varying studies. Some say that some women had weight gain and some did not, but weight gain can be due to PCOS itself as well.
Mm-hmm. Okay, ma'am. And what about the progesterone only option?
Yes, so progesterone only option is also a very good idea, because usually what is happening in polycystic ovaries is that there is excess of estrogen and testosterone hormones or excess of insulin, and when we supplement the hormone which is deficient, which is progesterone, or progesterone kam kyun ho raha hai, because the ovulation is not happening. So after ovulation usually the progesterone hormone rises. For these women there is less of progesterone, so various options are available to supplement the progesterones in second half of cycle. They can be in the form of oral, or they are injectable also, like Depo-Provera. They can also be implanted under the skin in subcutaneous tissue, that is Implanon. And for some women, they also would like to use an intrauterine device which has progesterone, and it comes by name of LNG IUS, which is also a good option. It is for women who have irregular bleeding, and their symptoms are very well managed using this form of method.
Okay. So is there birth control bad for PCOS? Like, who is not the right candidate for combined pills?
So as we talked about, some pills have mild to moderate side effects as well. For women who have advanced aged, who are smokers, who are obese, they are diabetic, hypertensive, or have dyslipidemia, means lipid profile is not good, jinki history of thrombophilia hai ya thromboembolism hai, for them oral pill is not the right choice. And when we are prescribing oral pills, only it is after detailed history and according to the WHO guidelines, jo kehti hai that there are some medical eligibility criteria for contraceptive use in women, and based on that only we give these contraceptives. So it is not a blanket treatment for everyone who has polycystic ovaries.
Yes, ma'am. Right, ma'am. And is there a difference between polycystic ovaries and PCOS?
Yes, ma'am. Polycystic ovaries is just an appearance of the ovary on ultrasound. It can be associated with no symptom, so we don't need to worry about. But polycystic ovarian syndrome will not only have polycystic ovaries on ultrasound, but associated with metabolic sign and symptoms which are related to PCOS. So women who are symptomatic, that means they have an ultrasound appearance, they have weight gain, they have hyperandrogenic symptoms like acne, hirsutism, for them PCOS is a disease, or if you call it, is a syndrome, and it has multiple problems associated with it, which is due to imbalance of the female hormones.
Okay. And talking about the symptoms, are you born with PCOS or do you develop it?
Yes. So PCOS, yeah. If we talk about what are the causes of PCOS, lifestyle is one of them. But yes, genetics also plays a role. Almost 50% of women who have PCOS have some or the other genetic history, or in their families some women might have had irregular periods, but maybe they were not diagnosed, so we did not know. But usually it starts at puberty, or sometimes even manifests in reproductive age as well.
Okay. And many women think that is birth control pill the only option for PCOS?
So yes, Mac, we have to first understand that PCOS women, are they married, are they unmarried, or irrespective of that, whether they are looking for a contraceptive as well, because they are sexually active. So, and whether they want to have a pregnancy or they don't want to have a pregnancy. Mm-hmm. So oral contraceptives will do them two benefits. One is that their pregnancy will be prevented, and another thing is that their side effects or whatever problem they are facing due to PCO will also be handled. So number one is the contraceptive pill that we are talking about. Other birth control options can be like for any other person, like use of male condoms, use of intrauterine devices which we call Copper T. So there are other options also available if they are looking for contraceptive and have PCOD at the same time.
And talking about the options, so how do you treat PCOS without birth control pills?
Yeah, so there are some women who do not fit into the medical eligibility criteria which we talked about WHO, and they have contraindication to be given the contraceptive pills. So what are the options that we have? Number one is the lifestyle, which most of us talk about, the home remedies, being active, regularly exercising, because that helps to balance the insulin resistance. Also, exercise helps to lower your blood sugar levels. Another thing is maintaining a healthy weight and BMI, because that will normalize the androgen levels and restore ovulation. And third thing is the diet that you are taking, which is a low carbohydrate and high fat diet, which will normalize the insulin levels and help to a large extent. So if we say that how can we treat PCOS without birth control, one is this holistic approach, which includes your lifestyle. Another thing is sometimes women who have acne, who have hirsutism or hyperandrogenic side effects, for them, we can also give anti-androgens like spironolactone and cyproterone.
Okay. And what happens if PCOS is left untreated?
Yes, we should never ignore the symptoms of PCOS, that we are not menstruating or cycle is getting delayed. How does it affect my health? But yes, it does, because we are altering the natural rhythm. It increases the risk of endometrial cancer in the long run, because there is no ovulation, so there is no progesterone which is being produced. Mm-hmm. While PCOS itself is not life-threatening, but there are high risk of complications in the long term, like impaired glucose tolerance, type 2 disease, diabetes, heart problems, liver inflammation, and so many other things.
Okay, ma'am. And many women have insulin resistance. So when insulin resistance happens, like mm-hmm. doctors give metformin, like diabetes. So yeah, so does metformin help?
So yes, metformin will help to a large extent, especially the risk of developing diabetes in pregnancy or in the long run. That will really help. It acts like a insulin sensitizer, and it will also reduce the glucose production in the liver, and ultimately by countering the insulin resistance, it reduces the production of androgens, matlab testosterone hormone, which is responsible for androgenic side effects. It will not be very good to regularize cycles as the contraceptive pills do. It will not be as effective, but it has a very good effect on cholesterol levels, lipid profile, maybe insulin, and in those terms, it is better than oral contraceptive pills. It also helps to assist in weight loss and will prevent extra weight gain, also reducing the risk of diabetes in the long run.
Okay. So let's conclude the session by if you give some good home message for women.
Yes, Meg. So combined contraceptive pills that we just spoke about, we don't need to worry about taking these pills, because there are benefits also other than only risk. They will rebalance the female hormones. We don't need to ignore that missed period is okay, because it is a natural body rhythm. And what I would like to say is that don't let PCOD defeat you. Don't feel miserable and fix your underlying problem with us. And best remedy nowadays is to complement our modern allopathic medicine with holistic approach. So if we follow both the things together, it will help to a large extent in managing these problems. And the fear of taking OCPs should not be in your mind, and make everything clear, whatever doubts that you have. And we also have a form which is in our attached with our video. Anyone who is looking for a free consultation, we are there to guide you. You can call us, you can fill that form, and we will get back to you.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much for taking your time out and clearing all the doubts regarding it. So thank you.
Thank you.
It was a great session.
Yeah, bye.